Random mess is random. Hey guys, sorry I haven't made a new video in a while, but I've been busy with finishing up my first year of college. I'm going back for my second year in about a month. And working and honestly not being as productive as I want to be, sadly. So I figured it was time to do a new video with me this time, as most of the stuff I've done now is mainly regular show and cap and Mikey tributes. Yeah, probably not the best idea. But anyways, I thought I'd share with you guys something that I never really put out on YouTube before, but it's really not that private of a detail for me, because everyone I know, almost everyone I know, knows that I have it, so I figured I'd share it with you guys. When I was 17, I was diagnosed with having Asperger's syndrome. For those of you who don't know what Asperger's is, it's basically low-level autism in which you don't know how to carry yourself in a conversation when you want to. And if you don't want to, you tend to zone everyone else out, and you don't want to be part of social situations very often. You tend to have an average to higher IQ than most people. You speak in a matter-of-fact voice, kind of like how I'm doing right now. Or am I? Post in the comments if I am. sometimes humor flies over your head, and sarcasm and such. You can become a bit non-attentive and forgetful. Just a little bit, though. Not too bad. When you don't know how to carry yourself in a conversation, often there's abrupt changes in between subjects. And if there's a subject you really like, you'll like it to the point of obsession, and you'll talk about it for hours on end, even when it's one-sided. And this last effect, I thought I'd show you guys because it's kind of affected my likes. The biggest indicator of that would be the collection of movies that I have, books that I have, and CDs that I have. Don't believe me? Check this out.
Sorry about the dark smudges on the lens. It's cracked and I don't know how to fix it. Let's start off with the top shelf. Across the Universe. That's because of my Beatles obsession. Back to the Future kind of got into. Batman. That's what I'm into right now. Beatles, of course. Bubba Hotep. Bruce Campbell for the win. Evil Dead. And Army Darkness. Again, Bruce Campbell for the win. Elvis. I'm quite a fan of the King. Harry Potter. Indiana Jones I have on VHS.
For those of you who don't know what VHS is, it's a black cartridge with videotape inside it you put into a VCR drive. Just an explanation for those who didn't grow up as a 90s kid. I probably made myself look like an idiot, but moving on.
James Bond. All of them are pretty freaking sweet. Skyfall is my favorite. Jeff Dunham. Kappa Mikey, of course. I recently got all two seasons on. Michael Jackson, huge king of pop. My name is Bruce. See Evil Dead and Bubba Hotep for comments. Nightmare on Elm Street. Pitch Perfect. It is still very good. I cannot wait for the sequel myself. Queen, one of my favorite bands, again. Resident Evil, in my opinion, one of the best video game series of all time. The Rocky films, pure epicness in filmmaking. Scott Pilgrim, also have all the graphic novels, we'll get to those later. Sherlock Holmes, Robert Downey Jr. and Jude Law. Star Wars, need I say more? Tenacious D, The Three Stooges, Titanic, It and Across the Universe are the only two romance movies that I actually love. And Tommy Boy and Black Sheep, Transformers and Wayne's World.
Over here's the graphic novels I have. Don't know if you can see that. There's Kingdom Hearts, Dragon Ball Z.
Could have sworn I had a Yu-Gi-Oh! One here somewhere. All six volumes of Scott Pilgrim, I don't need to tell you. Oh, there's the Yu-Gi-Oh! One.
I'm also a big fan of Titanic, obviously. Titanic and Illustrated History, one of the best books there is. As well as Ghost of the Abyss. Can't really see it underneath this wrinkled old dust cover.
Big fan of the Beatles, don't have to tell you. John Lennon is an awesome and very funny writer. Complete Beatles recording sessions. Really groovy stuff right there. I was a big fan of the US presidents back when I was a wee laddie. So that would explain all the presidents books I have there.
Clive Cussler as well, one of my favorite authors.
Sorry if I'm going on a tangent here, but again, Asperger's has messed with my brain and made it silly. Did PewDiePie's brofist noise. Let's get to the comic books, since we're down there. All of it is Batman. Batman Chronicles, great if you want to read what the early 30s and 40s Batman comics are all about. Dark Knight Returns in year one. Frank Miller at his best with Batman. The Killing Joke, can't go wrong. Arkham Asylum will scare the crap out of you. Gotham by Gaslight, think year one combined with Victorian era Gotham City. Haunted Night, Long Halloween. Jeff Loeb and Tim Sale. Well, probably doesn't mean anything to those who don't like comics or don't read them. Dark Knight Strikes Again, that's when Frank Miller started to go a little bit on the crazy side. It's still pretty good, but focus way too much on satire. This one right here. Oops. There we go. Batman Nine Lives. Batman back in 1940s noir. Batman Hush. Can't go wrong with that. It's an absolute favorite of mine. So is All-Star Batman and Robin, even though Frank Miller's lost his mind there. Heart of Hush, R.I.P. Very well-written stuff by Grant Morrison and Paul Dini. Or Paul Dini and Grant Morrison. That's one of the backwards. Batman and Robin, again by Grant Morrison. Kevin Smith of Jay and Silent Bob wrote Batman the Widening Gyre. It's a dark story, but it's actually pretty funny at the same time. Earth 1 is really good. Got the comic book that bridges Arkham City with Arkham Asylum. And the New 52 stuff. The Evil Dead comic book adaptation. Resident Evil. It's really good. And Tank Girl. Because I seen Nostalgia Critic's review of it and thought I'd look at the comics to see how good they were. Hopefully you're sticking with me through this video. And I hope you remember to take your to take your whiskey shots every time I introduce a new interest. I'm just kidding, I didn't tell you to do that. Look at me being nuts. Let's check out the last on our list by music. Almost all of the Beatles albums right here, except for the original Let It Be. I couldn't find that one. Every one a masterpiece. All of it is really good, so it's hard to choose a favorite. These three at the top are very special to me. America's Midwest Ambassadors in Music, I went on that trip to Europe 2 years ago. Blaine Hotchkiss is a friend of mine. This album was for his senior project.
Look at that guy, he's anxious.
Funk is also very special to me. This guy was my old pottery teacher for 2 summers back when I was a kid. He died on 9/11/2008 after he ran his van into a horse. It's been 5 years now, but I still miss him as if his death was yesterday. John, might as well zoom in. There we go. John Tesh, Big Band and Big Band Christmas. Beach Boys. Yes, you're seeing that right, Big Time Rush. But hey, it's not One Direction. So don't hate on me for that. Cheap Trick, CCR, Great Bell is actually pretty good. Beatles would be proud of him, in my opinion. Elton John, Gorillaz, very nice. Grease, haven't listened to Maroon 5 much, but they're okay. I can live with that. Monkees are really good. Naked Brothers Band, haven't listened to them in a long time. Shine Down and The Who, haven't listened to Shine Down, period. That's the Dark Knight Rises original soundtrack. There's Elvis, Green Day, John Lennon, Elvis's daughter, and Paramore. Random Percy is random. There's Michael Jackson off to this side. All of his original studio albums. That black box is bad, 25. Probably can't see that. There's Queen right here. One of the other studio albums. Random iPod cord is random. Elvis. Random Mozart is random. Queen Greatest Video Hits and George Harrison Living in the Material World. So, that is pretty much it. I know. I just wanted to tell you guys about my having Asperger's and how it's affected my personal likes and such. What do you guys think of some of my likes and my obsessions? Tell me what you guys think. Post it in the comments. If you found this video boring and kind of a tangent, sorry, that's just me sometimes.
Like I said, with Asperger's, sometimes you get to talking about something for a long time, and it tends to be one-sided. It's a good thing I'm talking to a camera in this case. So, let me rip off Tobuscus here for a second. Bless your face. If you sneeze during this tangent that branched off on many different subjects, bless you. And that's it. Peace out.